When I was born, I was HIV positive. And when I turned 5, I had symptoms of AIDS. Mm-hmm. I had had fungus in my brain, blood infections, mm-hmm. pneumonia. I went cold blue a couple of times. And that's when I was about 5, they said I was full-blown AIDS. And right now, I'm doing really good.
What's the hardest part for you, Hydeia? Living with this disease?
Basically, that's like when your friends die. Mm-hmm.
Like?
The hardest part is you like love them and you always lose a friend to AIDS. Hard, but especially, I don't think it's real hard. Harder on the parents than on me. They're friends and stuff, and you love them a lot, and mm-hmm. you get real close. Mm-hmm. And a lot of my friends that have died of AIDS, no one really knows how long anybody's gonna live, because I don't put myself like, oh, you have AIDS, or I could go outside and get hit by a bus tomorrow, and you never know. If you stay in your bed and feel sorry for yourself and don't get up with the birds and just sit there and say, well, I'm gonna die, why get up and try and make a difference? Mm-hmm. But when you say, well, today's another day, I can get up, I can do something, make something positive.
People still recognize me as a little girl from TV with AIDS. It happens at the weirdest times. I could be in the airport and someone will say, are you that little girl? And they'll whisper, with AIDS? And I just laugh and I say yes. Since I was on Oprah's show, I have been traveling around the world, spreading awareness about HIV/AIDS, prevention, advocating for treatment and care, and really just spreading the message to people about prevention. I was at the height of my career, and I'm like 15, and those are my teen years. Those are the years where you're like supposed to mess up and you're supposed to find yourself. And it was like so much pressure to be perfect. And there was a point where I really resented speaking. I resented being public. It became too much. And I dealt with low self-esteem and I dealt with depression. And I really had to find my inner peace. We don't do the why me, why do I have AIDS, why did this happen to me?
I've done everything the same. I live like a regular person. I do daily activities just like anyone else does.
Dating with AIDS. Well, there's a guy who I thought I was madly in love with, and he couldn't deal with my status. And I became a secret, like, oh, we can hang out, but at my house. Or we go to the movies, but across town. And so that really played with my psyche. It took me a long time to identify that the problem wasn't me, it was him. I was supposed to live past the age of 5. I will be 30 in June. In 5 years, I plan to have my own community center, my own nonprofit organization, maybe married, no kids yet. So I got so much to accomplish. I don't have time for kids.